Tantor Audio, a division of Recorded Books, presents The Power of Colors, the path to self-healing and personal transformation through Native American ancient wisdom, by Noah Goldhirsh. Narrated by Siiri Scott. Publisher's note: this audiobook includes bonus material. Please visit tantor.com and type The Power of Colors into the search box. Follow the link to the book's page, then, under the Supplemental Content section, please enter the access code HEALING, and then click the Unlock button to access the bonus material. The code should be entered in all lowercase letters. All figures and tables referenced in this audiobook can be found in the bonus material. The birth of this book. Over 30 years of studying and working in the field of complementary medicine have culminated in the writing of this book. Over the course of these years, worldviews on spiritual and material reality have changed, and today, more and more people acknowledge the importance of spirituality in our lives. Treatments, lectures, courses, and workshops on spiritual issues, which used to be considered taboo, have now become public knowledge. The spiritual way of thinking, once considered alien and extraordinary, is now acknowledged and respected, and my personal world and the world around me have changed unrecognizably. When I was a little girl, I was always asked what I wanted to be when I grew up. Looking back today, I am amazed by that little girl's connection to spiritual and cosmic knowledge, that child who wandered alone among the trees and the woods surrounding the neighborhood houses, gazing at the sky, the earth, plants and trees, talking to animals, and dreaming of healing people. I imagined sick people coming to me to be healed. The journey towards spiritual and practical healing became my way of life, and I use many diverse methods of healing, teaching, and conveying the knowledge I receive from the universe. This book concentrates the wealth of knowledge I have accumulated over the years by diagnosis through color therapy, energy work, and spiritual healing according to a spectrum of colors. I have focused on creating a handbook that you can use to connect with the theory of light and color, learning new things about yourselves and the surrounding world. The laws of physics and spirit show us that the universe consists of energy and light, and my wish for us all is that we may connect to the light of the universe and live a beneficial life of enlightenment and joy. May this book light the way toward the infinite, colorful light of the cosmos. The colors of our world in daily life. We are born into a colorful, diverse world where we are surrounded by the hues of plants, trees, earth, water, sky, and the creatures that live around us. The science of physics proves that our world is made of light frequencies and each color has its own wavelength. Our bodies are built to absorb color frequencies, and consequently, we immediately respond to the presence of light and color, which directly affects our physical and mental health. Throughout history, humanity has used color in varying ways, and each culture has techniques for using color according to its beliefs. In ancient techniques of color healing, various colors would be applied to the body. The person's illness would determine the color of the food eaten. Materials of various colors would be used for healing. Gems and crystals would be placed on the body, and mandalas drawn for health and recovery. The indigenous Native Americans would paint their faces and bodies in various colors according to events in their lives, and each color had spiritual, mental, and practical meaning. To this day, in India, color therapy is used by means of gems and wonderfully colorful clothing and food, emphasizing the third eye with a colorful dot. Tibetans paint amazing mandalas made of colored sand in order to attain healing and spiritual transcendence. Doctors of traditional Chinese medicine refer to the color of clothing and food, and Judaism refers to the high priest who wore 12 colorful precious stones on his tunic. Throughout human history, great significance has been attributed to skin color and the color of eyes and hair. For many years, dark-skinned people were seen as slaves without rights because of the color of their skin, and to this day, a person's skin color often determines how society relates to him. Humanity's attitude toward color has shifted over the years, but color is nonetheless an inseparable part of our personality and culture. Thanks to the wonders of technology today, an abundance of colors can be produced with ease and speed, and so it is easier and simpler to buy many items in varying colors. But most people are still unaware of the ability of color to bring about physical and mental healing and balance. When people learn to know colors beyond their daily uses and become acquainted with color therapy, they discover that healing through color is effective and useful as a therapeutic tool in itself, as well as a support for any other kind of treatment. We can enjoy the healing, balancing properties of colors in many diverse ways, and the most basic way to use color is by eating healthy, natural food of varying colors every day. In order to enjoy the full spectrum of colors, I recommend spending time daily in natural surroundings and taking pleasure in sunlight. We can choose a stone or stones in colors that suit us and keep them in a pocket or wear them on a chain, a bracelet, or a ring. And of course, we can wear different colored clothing every day in order to reinforce our immune system. In order to bring the whole color spectrum naturally into the home each day, we can hang crystals at the windows to reflect diffracted sun rays. In order to arrive at the best results and create a harmonious, healthy home, I recommend painting the home in colors that suit us, adding accessories in colors compatible with the different areas of the home, and using the art of feng shui and personally harmonious colors. When turning to color therapy, there are many ways of using colors in the various kinds of therapy available throughout the world. The color spectrum has enormous significance in our world, and we can use it to improve all aspects of our lives. This book is a collection of data I have acquired over a period of 30 years on the subjects of light, color, and spirituality in our lives, and it provides tools for physical and mental healing through the use of color. I believe that accurate diagnosis is an important and powerful aspect of any treatment. This book details a number of diagnostic methods and treatments developed to help each person get to know himself, understand the meaning of his life, how best to manifest his abilities, and use color as a tool for improving physical and mental health. I am certain that in the years to come, we will increasingly understand the meaning of colors and will be able to turn the use of color therapy into a practical tool for daily use that is available to everyone. The ability to use colors is inherent in all of us from the moment we come into the world. Over the course of the years as a therapist and teacher, I've realized that the first instinct of any human being, a gut feeling, is wonderfully precise. When we are attracted to a color, we should relate to it as a mental and physical need. The accepted fashion, which changes according to designers' whims, tends to disrupt our basic sense of color and our energetic choices, So it is advisable for all of us to listen to our inner voice, integrate our intuitive knowledge, and learn how to use colors that best suit us in every situation of our lives, even if they aren't fashionable. Over the years, I've seen many people heal with the help of color. For example, one of my patients managed to sleep better after years of insomnia when she made massive use of the color blue. A patient who suffered from terrible back pain at night wrapped his hips in a green, pink, and orange scarf, and the pain immediately subsided. A patient who suffered from hoarseness put a chain of turquoise stones around her neck, and the hoarseness vanished within 5 minutes. Animals also respond wonderfully to color. Many years ago, I was visiting a client whose 5-year-old dog was restless, angry, couldn't sleep or eat properly, and peed in the house. The dog's collar was red, and she slept on a red and blue blanket in a bad location in terms of feng shui. I advised my friend to replace the dog's collar with a pink one, give her a green blanket to sleep on, and change her place in the house. Within a day of carrying out the changes, the dog became significantly calmer, stopped peeing in the house, and started to eat and sleep better. Using color is cheap and simple to do, and the results are incredible. When you don't know which color to choose, check the books, ask a color therapy specialist, and listen to your inner voice. Finally, I wish to clarify the use of the term Indians. In Hebrew, this term denotes Native Americans. The English term Indians was accepted for many years, although its origin was mistaken. When Christopher Columbus arrived in America, he mistakenly thought he'd reached India, and so he called the indigenous people Indios. The label eventually became Indians in the American language, later perceived as derogatory. In recent years, they've stopped using the term, among others. First Nation tribes self-identify as Native American Indigenous Peoples or First Nation Peoples. The use of colors in daily life. When wishing to use color in daily life, the simplest way is to wear different colored clothing according to our needs. During my years of teaching color therapy, I have developed unique teaching and diagnostic methods. In order to prove the effects of color on the human body, I chose a particular color each week, during which all my students wear mainly this color. The students are asked to note down their experiences over the course of the week, paying particular attention to their physical and emotional sensations and feelings, the quality of their sleep, and their sleeping habits. When the students convene for their lesson at the end of the week, they discover that they share similar physical and emotional experiences as a result of the consistent use of a particular color during the week. These experiences relate to the classic effect of a color on body and mind, and on each one's personal wheel of colors. When we wear a particular color, it has direct impact on our body and mind. To a large extent, the fashion industry dictates the colors we choose to wear and combine. When we are freed from the conventions of dress and color common to our environment at a particular time, each of us tends to choose the color that suits us. When our choice of clothing and color is unlimited, we choose the color our body needs without taking fashion into account. However, since we are not unaffected by the environment, it is relatively easy to influence our choices. Our body relates to colors as it does to any energetic nourishment, and so we must understand that when we intuitively choose the colors we wear, the color we choose is actually the color we need at that moment in order to function in the best way possible. When we use a particular color over time, the body grows accustomed to it and becomes addicted to this color. For example, women who wear primarily black clothing discover after a while that the color they find physically and mentally most comfortable is the color black, because the body grows used to wearing clothes in one main color and, in fact, becomes addicted to the color black. It is advisable and advantageous to wear clothes of all colors, according to the needs of the body, to avoid excessive use of one color, and to frequently change the colors we wear. Each of us has a personal wheel of colors that is tailored to our needs and reflects our personality. Later in the book, you will discover your own personal wheel of colors and learn how to use it in daily life. People with cancer should avoid wearing green clothes because this color encourages the growth and development of body cells. People with high blood pressure should avoid wearing clothes in shades of red because over time, this color could raise blood pressure. People with low blood pressure should remember that wearing blue clothes for an extended period could lower blood pressure. It is desirable and advantageous to wear colors that match the location of the chakras in the body and to wear colors in a balanced way. Paying daily attention to our choice of color according to our needs yields wonderful results. Make sure you have clothes in all the colors of the rainbow in your closet and allow yourselves to intuitively wear the color that will benefit your body. For example, wearing blue pajamas and using blue sheets could help people fall asleep easily and enjoy a sound sleep. Wearing a blue scarf or a necklace of turquoise stones could help a sore, hoarse throat. For many women, wearing orange underwear or placing an orange towel on the belly area soothes menstrual pain. And for many men, wearing orange underwear or trousers and eating orange food helps treat urinary problems or erectile dysfunction. By paying attention to your body's response to each color, you will be able to try various color combinations and improve your physical and mental state by wearing clothes in the appropriate color. Colors and their meaning. Red. Red is the warmest, most animating color and relates to sexuality, activity, and belief. Red is the color of blood and the root chakra, helping us to wake up, raise our level of energy, and act swiftly because it raises our blood pressure, stimulates, and arouses us. The color red frequently signifies danger or emergency, and many illnesses are characterized by a redness of the skin. An excess of red in the human aura can indicate anger, danger, or acute illness. When someone is angry, he turns red. His blood pressure rises, and he tends to flare up, which is attributed to an excess of the color red in his body at that moment. The color red has a strong effect on our bodies. It relates to fertility, sexual attraction and temptation, signifying sexuality and sexual arousal. Red is a prominent color that attracts attention. We notice anyone in a red hat from a distance, a red cap on a bottle, or a red advertisement. Excessive red could cause irritability, high blood pressure, anger, and hyperactivity. In certain places in the world, teachers are forbidden to wear red clothes to class because this color apparently makes it hard for students to sit quietly and listen to the teacher, and they become irritable and restless. Several years ago, many women in our country started to dye their hair various shades of red according to the fashion. Several of my clients who changed the color of their hair to red started to suffer from high blood pressure, although previously their blood pressure had been perfectly normal. Assuming that it was the red color that was causing the high blood pressure, I suggested they return to their original color. When I suggested to a delightful client that she go back to her original color, brown, she resisted at first for reasons of fashion and beauty. But when she finally agreed, her blood pressure immediately dropped to its normal state. The color red can help those with low blood pressure to raise their blood pressure naturally. It helps people who have difficulty waking and getting up in the morning, giving them a sense of energy and strength. However, excessive use of red over time should be avoided because it can cause irritability and exhaustion. The color red hastens the healing process of the body, helping to improve the blood flow, speed up the closing of sores, and their healing process. An easy way to use color after surgery is to wear a necklace or bracelet of red stones, like rubies, red coral, garnets, and red jasper, etc. The use of red on the upper body could overstimulate the energy, raising the blood pressure, so it is preferable to wear red mainly on the lower body, using items such as red underwear, red socks, red shoes, a bracelet with a red stone, keeping a red stone in a pocket, and so on. Red is a warming color, and wearing red socks can help those who suffer from cold feet and slow blood flow in the extremities. Excessive use of the color red should be avoided in cases of high blood pressure, hyperactivity, anger, irritability, and a tendency to outbursts of rage. Yellow. The sun appears to be yellow, and so we attribute the color yellow to light, openness, warmth, and love. This color appears in nature in the feathers of chicks, the fur of kittens and puppies, and some infants and young children have yellow hair. The color yellow reinforces in us the desire to love someone, protect, and look after him. Women who dye their hair a yellow blonde color immediately notice a difference in their feelings and in the environment's attitude to them. Research shows that blonde women receive preferential treatment and are considered naive and very attractive, but they're also perceived as childish, dependent, and lacking in knowledge or opinions of their own, and they're often regarded as younger than their age. The color yellow boosts the intellect, and research has found that writing on yellow paper increases concentration and creativity, and that yellow markers help emphasize and remember words and sentences. The color yellow particularly impacts the nerves, muscles, and digestive system, and excessive use of yellow should be avoided by people suffering from nervous and mental complaints. We attribute happiness to the color yellow, and in China, it is considered an imperial hue, related with cheerfulness and children. The appropriate use of yellow has a warm and pleasant effect, and painting houses a yellowish shade introduces an earth element. It is usually preferable to choose a pale or pastel shade of yellow because these shades transmit the energy of yellow in the pleasantest, most soothing way. When dark buildings are painted a warm yellow, they become light, warm, open, and inviting. This color affects our digestive system. In the West, we often consume the color yellow artificially in food, for instance, various kinds of snacks. Excessive consumption of the artificial color yellow could cause problems regarding attention and concentration, hyperactivity, etc. It is advisable to consume the color yellow in natural, healthy, non-processed foods. Yellow is the color of the solar plexus chakra and helps us fuel the fire of our inner will, daring, and progress to create our futures independently filled with a passion for life. Blue. Blue is the most prevalent color in our world. The blue planet is blessed with blue oceans, and most people choose blue as their favorite color. Blue is the color of intuition, and it connects us to our inner voice and channeling capacity. This color is considered cold, and it cools and soothes, lowers blood pressure, imbues us with a sense of peace, and helps us take care of sleep problems. For those suffering from insomnia, it is advisable to use blue pajamas and sheets. People who suffer from ongoing problems with sleep can paint the walls of their bedroom blue, and in certain cases, even use a bluish nightlight, 5 watts, in the bedroom. It is also advisable to wear blue clothing during the day and drink water from bottles made of blue glass. According to feng shui, the color blue stimulates learning in all fields, and learning in an area where the color blue predominates, and/or sitting on blue chairs, helps children with attention deficit disorders, enabling them to learn well and calmly. The color blue is advisable in places of learning, conventions, conferences, etc. The color blue helps lower blood pressure and alleviate stress, encourages emotional release, reinforces intuition, promotes spiritual knowledge, and helps cope with difficult situations in a calm and balanced manner. People with low blood pressure are advised to take care with the color blue. However, blue is considered a true healing color for all people, particularly when it appears in its natural form, blue flowers, natural blue stones, streams, rivers, sea, and sky. A personal experience. Excessive use of one color has a strong impact on a person's body and soul. I was invited for a feng shui consultation at the home of a woman who was worried about her teenage son's behavior. The mother told me her son comes home from school, goes into his room, and immediately falls asleep. She said that he is often asleep in his room, and it is hard to wake him. As a result, he doesn't do his homework or spend time with his friends. Upon entering her son's room, I was astonished to find that both the walls and the ceiling were painted blue. The closet, desk, and chair were blue, as was his bed, and as for his bedding, well, you've probably guessed, blue. I stood there and started to yawn. I advised the mother to change the colors in the room and use the entire color spectrum. The shift in her son was remarkable and instantaneous. The mother called me to say he had completely come alive. Green. The color green is at the center of the color spectrum, and, in color therapy, constitutes a balancing hue with wonderful physical and mental healing qualities. We feel the benefits of natural green surroundings because for hundreds of thousands of years, we were accustomed to living in nature, among green plants and trees. Physically and mentally, we need them and cannot exist without them. Spending time in nature gives us a direct link to healing through the color of natural green, which reinforces our immune system and strengthens the healing powers of our body and soul. The color green is considered the color of willpower, which reinforces and invigorates us, encouraging us to grow, flourish, and develop. Many city dwellers experience an ongoing lack of the color green because they live far from nature, in industrialized cities, amid concrete blocks of homes and offices. When we go out into nature and stand under a tree on a soft green lawn, we naturally tend to take a deep breath and smile. The organic, healing green of trees and plants is ours in abundance when spending time in a natural and green environment, helping us to heal and restore the body to health and balance. The color green can help treat respiratory problems like asthma, pneumonia, etc., and is particularly effective when combined with the color orange. Many years ago, when people fell ill with lung disease, such as tuberculosis, they were sent away to sanatoriums located in forests among trees and plants. Doctors realized that when patients spent many hours outside in sunlight among green trees, a spontaneous healing process took place and terminally ill patients were cured. A natural green can help any illness, but it is important to pay attention to the amount. For instance, women should be careful not to wear too much green in the first trimester of pregnancy, when the cells of the embryo are forming. Cancer patients should avoid using artificial instead of natural green because it might increase the uncontrolled growth of cells in the body. Consuming healthy, natural, green, cooked or uncooked foods can help to improve our health. The color green improves our mental health, activates the will, and the use of healing stones and green clothing, houseplants, and spending time in a natural green environment fosters development, activity, flourishing, and growth. A personal experience. One of my clients was hospitalized in intensive care with a blocked intestine. In addition to the healing treatment I gave her, I brought her a potted parsley plant and wrapped its base in pink paper. The parsley plant is very important in the treatment process, as it is known for its powerful ability to concentrate energy, bioenergy, and the color green helps to heal disease and balance the human body. The pink color of the wrapping paper was intended to calm the patient and her surroundings. The doctors and nurses were astonished at the sight of a parsley plant, but allowed me to put it on the locker beside the patient's bed. From that moment, the recovery of my client was incredibly swift, and within a few hours, she was transferred from intensive care to the Department of Internal Care. As I picked up the plant, nurses approached me and said that her recovery was a medical miracle. The nurses asked me if I'd agree to leave the plant in the room so they could put it next to another patient who'd been lying there for 2 weeks in critical condition. Naturally, I agreed, and to our joy, the patient quickly recovered. I warmly recommend taking a parsley plant to any hospital patient and wrapping its base in pink or orange paper. It is truly a gift of health that helps recovery and, in my opinion, is infinitely preferable to the flowers most people tend to bring. Pink. Pink is the most soothing color. The color of the heart chakra is an aligned combination of pink and green. Pink is usually defined as a feminine color. Attributing gender to it is both mistaken and misleading, since the color pink soothes, gladdens, and benefits every human being, regardless of religion, gender, or race. As a result of this mistaken definition, many men suffer from a lack of the color pink. Pink is a color that enables us to share feelings, and many men may have difficulty sharing their feelings, also because from a young age, they are deliberately prevented from using this color. The color pink is calming and encourages us to be sincere and honest with ourselves, to share our feelings with others, and effectively release emotional distress. The color pink encourages conversation, peace, sharing, and understanding, helping us to open our hearts to love. When we wear something pink, or carry a pink stone for a time, this color helps us open our hearts, cry, share our feelings and secret dreams, and let go of emotional distress. The sources of all distress and disease is unresolved emotion, and since it is most important to be aware of our feelings and take care of any emotional problem as soon as possible, the color pink, which supports us emotionally, is known for its auxiliary powers in any treatment. Pink is considered the color of creativity because it is the color of our hands, which we use to do creative things and express ourselves and our way of life, writing, cooking, painting, sculpting, and so on. The use of the color pink in our daily lives encourages emotional freedom, true creativity that stems from the depths of the soul, and the ability to share our emotional life with others. White. The color white is considered the color of relationships in our lives because it contains all colors. Intrinsic to all relationships is an entire world, and the color white signifies the complexity of all relationships and its ability to unite all colors and turn them into a single, clear, clean color. White represents many different things in various cultures. Throughout the Western world, white is used to unite people during times of joy, celebration, and weddings, whereas in China, the color white traditionally relates to parting from the world, death, and mourning. And in Judaism, we bury our dead in white shrouds. In the olden days, only the rich and noble wore fine white clothes, as only wealthy people could afford fine white fabric and keep it clean. Most people in their daily lives wore simple clothing made of dark-colored, durable fabric, and white clothes became festive garments to be worn on special occasions. People who wear a white shirt to work are known to this day as white-collar employees, and over the years, have come to be considered as having respected work that is clean and easier than that of employees who are known as blue-collar workers, because they wear simple blue clothes to work. To this day, white is considered a respectable color that conveys reliability, and research indicates that marketing people sell more when they wear an ironed white shirt. Traditionally, doctors and nurses wear white clothes, and we tend to respect them greatly, particularly when we need their help. In Chinese medicine, white is the color of the metal element, and when we exaggerate its use, we tend to argue more and behave aggressively. Its uses in color therapy are varied and help people understand and resolve problems in relationships. The color white gives us a sense of cleanliness, hygiene, peace, and quiet. Purple. Purple is the color of the third eye chakra. It is considered a spiritual color that stimulates inspiration and reinforces our spiritual capacities. The color purple helps us to develop the unconscious, see the spiritual aspect of our lives, and attain self-fulfillment. It is related to spiritual and economic abundance, giving a sense of security to anyone who wears it. Purple teaches us gratitude for all the good in our lives, enabling us to see things differently, come to terms with our life lessons, to heal and close cycles in our lives. Purple supports people, helping to end relationships that aren't good for us. It encourages healing and change, filling us with a sense of abundance, self-esteem, gratitude, and joy. The color purple can help lower blood pressure, and sleeping between purple sheets or wearing purple pajamas can help people remember and internalize the meaning of night dreams, which are actually messages from the unconscious. Purple is a color that can help with any treatment, and it works wonderfully when combined with the color green. When using the color purple for the treatment of chronic disease, it helps people to understand why they are ill and to change behavior patterns. The color purple can help develop children's capacity for gratitude and help them to complete tasks and heal physically and mentally. Orange. Orange is the color of the family chakra and is considered energetic, cheerful, joyful, and antidepressive. The color orange is recommended for treating a lack of energy and helps improve and balance the flow of energy in the body. The use of orange on various parts of the body significantly affects them. The color orange on the chest area encourages the elimination of phlegm from the lungs. In the area of the urinary tract, it encourages good urinary output. And in the genital area, it balances hormonal processes. The color orange helps with diarrhea and constipation as it balances the elimination of substances from the body. For those suffering from prostate problems, it is advisable to wear orange underwear, preferably terry cloth underwear. To ease menstrual pain, it is advisable to put a heated orange towel on the painful area and, for relief of breastfeeding difficulties, wear an orange bra and an orange stone. Since the color orange drives and stimulates, it is best to avoid excessive use of orange when treating hyperactive children or children suffering from attention deficit disorder. In cases of despondency, depression, and lack of energy, it is advisable to eat food that is orange, wear orange clothing, and orange stones in order to raise the level of energy in the body. Orange is considered the color of studying because it combines red, the color of belief, and yellow, the color of love. And over the course of our lives, it is easier to study things we love and believe in. Orange encourages us to learn and develop different directions in our lives, and learning gives us many tools for a happier, healthier life, enabling us to use our energetic abilities to develop physically and spiritually. Orange invigorates, empowers, stimulates, encourages, and brings health. It is advisable to introduce the color orange into most treatments, and it works particularly well in combination with the color green. A personal experience. A student of mine had a 5-year-old son who'd suffered from a chronic runny nose since the age of 2. He had difficulty breathing and snored a lot at night. The doctors said he was very sensitive, but that apart from steam inhalations, etc., there wasn't much they could do. I advised my student to dress her son in an orange shirt and give him a green healing stone to wear. A few days later, she called to tell me that enormous quantities of mucus had come out. 2 weeks later, the child was breathing easily for the first time in 3 years and sleeping soundly all night. He felt so good in the orange shirt that even when he started first grade, he made sure to wear an orange vest under his school uniform and always kept a green stone in his pocket. Gray. Gray has a low energetic vibration, and an ongoing use of this color could dramatically lower the energy of the body, bringing about physical and mental exhaustion, boredom, sadness, depression, and unwillingness to act. Research shows that when the weather is gray and overcast and the sky gray, heart attacks, disease, depression, and suicide become more frequent. The color gray represents being in a rut, behaving conventionally, avoidance of expressing an independent opinion, and lack of daring. Gray people is an accepted name for those who lack uniqueness, who don't stand out, whose lives are boring, monotonous, and lacking in excitement. Among the Native Americans, the color gray signifies respect because it is the color of elders and scholars' hair, people who have experienced many things in their lives and acquired great knowledge, and whose words should be respected and honored. Many people discover that when they wear gray, they are respected by others around them. However, they also tend to relate to them as conventional and lacking in courage. Gray is particularly suitable for adolescents, as they feel restless and full of outbursts of energy. Wearing a gray garment soothes these unbalanced outbursts, giving adolescents a sense of self-respect and respect for others around them. Older people who wish to maintain their level of energy need to use the color gray judiciously because their level of energy tends to drop with age, and excessive use of the color gray might cause overtiredness, boredom, and depression. Generally speaking, it is advisable for everyone to avoid excessive use of the color gray in their clothing, the color of internal walls, etc., in order to avoid a chronic lack of energy. Brown. Brown signifies earth and is considered the color of stability, practicality, and grounding, which connects us to the practical side of life. The color brown is very common in foods, frequently appearing in comfort food, chocolate, bread, snacks, etc., to which we turn when we're distressed. The color brown helps us feel protected. It gives us a sense of security and stability in our lives, enables us to return to our organic nature, to be grounded. It connects us to the fundamental, tangible, and practical will to live, to Mother Earth and health. Many energetic treatments advise walking barefoot on the earth or sea sand in order to connect with the healing, concentrated energy of the color brown in all its shades. Preparing healthy food for ourselves and others is highly recommended as a stabilizing therapy because when we cook or bake, we use the color brown in all its shades in a practical, significant way, an activity that connects us to our creativity, encouraging us to connect with our fundamental existence. The color brown is recommended for treating temporary or long-term situations where we lack a firm hold on reality. Situations where we are unable to concentrate, where we procrastinate, hesitate, in situations of insecurity and inability to act. The color brown helps us connect with reality and encourages us to take action, create, and enjoy a process of activity and its results. Rose. Rose, or fuchsia, increases a person's sensory and extrasensory capabilities. The color rose encourages people to see through their own eyes rather than the eyes of others, and respond to every sensation in a way unique to them, while occasionally supporting thoughts that the road they have taken is the only one, which makes it difficult to listen to the opinions of others. The color rose increases people's spiritual abilities, helping to treat the area of the heart chakra, together with the colors green and pink, enabling people to let go and say what is in their hearts, open up, see the situation from another perspective, be honest with themselves and those around them. Rose supports the color pink and encourages creativity, individuality, thinking differently, and the ability to see a situation from different perspectives. The color rose encourages flexibility of thought and encourages us to successfully change routine life patterns. Rose is the color attributed to uniqueness, encouraging new ideas, inventions, unconventional solutions for various situations, and the ability to think outside the box and swim against the current. Black. Native Americans consider the color black to be the most spiritual of all, because when we close our eyes, we disconnect from the external world and look inward. See the color black. The color black is related to mindfulness, in-depth reflection, meditation, and profound spiritual processes. Throughout human history, people have been afraid of the dark color of night. This is the time we close our eyes and sink into a sleep that severs us from daily reality, and we temporarily surrender our alertness and control over our lives. The dark night is accepted as a time for inward reflection, disconnection from reality, dreaming, and a release of urges. When we have difficulty seeing our environment clearly, we turn inward to deal with what is happening inside. He who looks outside dreams. He who looks inside awakes. Carl Jung. The color black is considered a protection against unwanted energies, and the finest protective stones are black, such as black tourmaline, onyx, and obsidian, etc. The color black protects our energetic environment and causes people to maintain a respectful distance from those who wear it, and it has become the accepted dress for anyone who wishes to protect himself and create a respectful distance from his environment, such as lawyers, judges, and religious figures. We live in a time of new discoveries, technological inventions, and swift, extreme changes that situate our daily life and thoughts at the center of the world picture and encourage intense preoccupation with the needs and desires of the individual. Consequently, the color black has become acceptable and popular. We should remember that excessive use of this color causes undue preoccupation with the inner self, self-judgment, worrying thoughts, but when we use the color black wisely and judiciously, it encourages us to observe ourselves and reflect on our lives in depth, to appreciate spiritual theories, and arrive at significant insights. Crystal. This color is attributed to the crown chakra, and since it is transparent and visibly contains all the colors of the rainbow, it is regarded as the color of transparency, clarity, and lucidity. Crystal helps us attain physical and mental clarity, enabling us to see the whole picture in varying life situations, understand the different aspects of a situation, think clearly, come to clear conclusions, with the ability to speak and act clearly, honestly, and directly. An ideal combination of colors utilizes the healing qualities of all colors, and when we use all the colors of the rainbow, we heal body and mind and find the right way to a full and happy life. Feng Shui specialists recommend hanging crystals at the window of our home in order to balance the flow of energy into the home. The diffraction of sun's rays at the corners of the crystal radiate all the colors on the spectrum into our home, helping the rainbow of colors enter our lives beneficially and pleasantly. The use of the full spectrum of colors is physically and mentally beneficial for us, so it is advisable to wear clothing of all colors, eat a variety of colored foods, wear stones of all colors, and be clear and transparent with ourselves and the world around us. The original Native American Wheel of Colors. The original Native American Wheel of Colors is a powerful, ancient diagnostic tool that accurately reflects a person's qualities, indicating his strengths and weaknesses. The wheel shows how a person's aptitudes find expression in daily life, enabling him to understand himself and manifest these aptitudes to the best of his ability. By means of the Native American Wheel of Colors, therapist and client are able to see the latter's abilities clearly, understand what stops him from fully manifesting his abilities, and recommend the best way to use his abilities in order to best manifest his calling. The wheel consists of 13 colors, and each person selects his wheel of colors independently or with the guidance of a therapist. The process of selecting a wheel of colors occurs once in a lifetime and cannot be repeated or changed. It is a one-time, intuitive, and energetic choice, and we must relate to this process with respect because the wheel of colors chosen is a personal, fixed, unchanging wheel that accompanies the person throughout his life. The process of selecting the personal wheel of colors. The process of selecting the personal wheel of colors takes place in a session that usually takes an hour. It is advisable to sit with a client in a quiet, calm room without external interruption. One may light candles and have healing stones and/or a flowering potted plant nearby, which contribute to an atmosphere of good, calm energy, helping the process of selecting colors to take place beneficially and pleasantly. Concentration is important in the selection process. We must devote all our attention to it. A. Give the client two sheets of A3 or A4 paper, a pastel color kit with 24 or 36 colors to a box, and a pencil or a pen. B. Instruct the client to write down in a vertical column the numbers from 1 to 13 in the order of his choice. He might not select the acceptable order, 1, 2, 3. It is very important he understand that the numbers should be selected according to his personal preference. In the process of selecting the numbers for the personal wheel of colors, each person chooses the numbers and arranges them as he wishes, with no time limit or pressure, and with complete awareness. This is a unique process of selection that will not be repeated. The selection process differs from one person to another, and most people tend to arrange the numbers according to their affiliation with particular numbers. Some people select the numbers in an organized fashion, writing and erasing. Others select the numbers intuitively and write them down relatively quickly, while others deliberate throughout the selection process and tend to change the numbers again and again. It is best to give the client several sheets of paper so he can choose the numbers freely and calmly. To make the selection process easier for the client, it is possible to make the process completely intuitive using a pack of 13 cards. Take 13 blank cards and write the number clearly on one side of each card. The reverse side of the card is left blank. Spread out the cards with the blank side facing upward and let the client choose card after card. Write down the numbers in the order of their choice. To help young children choose numbers for their personal wheel of colors, one may take 13 small wooden cubes and write a number on each one. Shuffle the cubes. Let the child choose the cubes one after another and write down the numbers for him. You can choose the numbers for the Native American Wheel of Colors any way you wish. If the client selects the numbers independently, we ask him to note them down in the order of their selection, in a vertical column from top to bottom on the right hand of the paper. For example, 9, 6, 8, 4, and so on. When all 13 numbers are listed in order on the paper, we ask the client to write down the names of the colors, which we then read out beside the numbers he has chosen. We read the client the classic list of colors, and he writes down the first color we read out beside the top number on his list, the next color beside the next number underneath, and so on. It is important to adhere to the order and make sure not to skip a number. The colors are read out in the following order: red, yellow, blue, green, pink, white, purple, orange, gray, brown, rose, black, crystal. For instance, 9, red, 6, yellow, 8, blue, 4, green, and so on. The process of drawing the wheel. The client now has a list of numbered colors. We instruct him to draw a circle. Some people will have difficulty drawing a circle without aid. Be patient. Encourage the client and make sure the circle is freely drawn without aid. The client determines the size and shape of the circle. We can allow the client to improve and fix his circle, but we shouldn't devote too much time to this process. There is a direct correlation between the size and form of the circle and the physical, mental state of the client. We instruct the client to draw another circle inside the one he has just drawn. The external wheel is divided into four segments according to the location of the numbers 3, 6, 9, 12 on the clock. Each quarter is divided into three parts. That is, on each quarter, we draw two more lines until the wheel.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.